Welcome to the lecture for BTech 4SEM subject data communication and computer networks. Myself Prakash Meena, assistant professor computer science and engineering, engineering college Ajmer. So today's topic is routing algorithms, and we will study about basic routing algorithms. What is routing algorithms and what is the principle of optimality. So we will start from here. So the main function of the network layer is routing packets from the source machine to the destination machine. In most networks, packets will require multiple hops to make the journey, and the only notable exception is for the broadcast network. But even routing is an issue if the source and destination are not on the same network segment. So the algorithm that choose the route and the data structure that they use are a major area of network layer design. And routing algorithm is that part of the network layer software responsible for deciding which output line in incoming packet should be transmitted on. If the network uses datagram internally, this decision must be made anew for every arriving data packet, since the best route may have changed since last time. And if network uses a virtual circuit internally, routing decisions are made only when a new virtual circuit is being set up. So data packets just follow the already established route. And later case is sometimes called session routing, because a route remains in force for an entire session. So if it is sometimes useful to make a distinction between routing, which is making the decision which route to use, and forwarding, which is what happens when a packet arrives. And one can think a router as having two processes inside it. One of them handles each packet as it arrives, looking up the outgoing line to use for it in the routing table. This process is forwarding, and the other process is responsible for filling in and updating the routing tables. That is where the routing algorithm comes in to play. And regardless of whether routes are chosen independently for each packet sent or only when new connections are established, certain properties are desirable in a routing algorithms, like correctness, simplicity, robustness, stability, fairness, and efficiency. So correctness and simplicity hardly requires comment, but the need for robustness must be less obvious at first. And once a major network comes on the air, it may be expected to run continuously for years without system-wide failures. And during that period, there will be hardware and software failure of any kind, and host routers and lines will fail repeatedly, and the topology will change many times. The routing algorithm should be able to cope with all these changes in the topology and traffic without requiring all jobs in all hosts to be aborted. And so stability is also an important goal for the routing algorithm. There exist routing algorithms that never converge to a fixed set of paths, no matter how long they run. And a stable algorithm reaches equilibrium and stay there. It should converge quickly too, and since communication may be disrupted until the routing algorithm has reached equilibrium. And fairness and efficiency may also sound obvious. Surely no reasonable person would oppose them, but as it turns out, they are often contradictory goals. So here is an example. You can see here a conflict between fairness and optimality. So as a simple example here, suppose there is enough traffic between A and A dash, between B and B dash, and between C and C dash to saturate the horizontal links. To maximize the total flow, then X to X dash traffic should be shut off altogether, and unfortunately X and X dash may not see it that way. Some compromise between global efficiency and fairness is individual connection is needed here. And before we can even attempt to find a trade-off between fairness and efficiency, we must decide what it is we seek to optimize. And minimizing the mean packet delay is an obvious candidate to send traffic through the network effectively, but so is maximizing total network throughput. And more, these two goals are also in conflict, since operating any queuing system near capacity implies a long queuing delay. And as a compromise, many networks attempt to minimize the distance a packet must travel, or simply reduce the number of hops a packet must make. And either choice tends to improve the delay and also reduce the amount of bandwidth consumed per packet, which tends to improve the overall network throughput as well. So the routing algorithm can be grouped into two major classes. Non-adaptive and adaptive. So non-adaptive algorithm do not base their routing decision on any measurements or estimate of the current topology and traffic, and instead the choice of the route to use to get from I to J is computed in advance, then offline and downloaded in the to the routers when the network is booted. And this procedure is sometimes called static routing, and because it does not respond to failure, static routing is mostly useful for situation in which the routing choice is clear. So here is an example. I think we have not okay we have not given here an example for this, so later on we will give the detail about this, so we skip the example. So next is adaptive algorithm. So in contrast, change their routing decision to reflect changes in the topology and sometimes changes in the traffic as well. This dynamic routing algorithm differs in where they get their information and when they change the routers and what matrix is used for optimization. So so the next is the optimality principle. Okay, we have completed adaptive algorithms and then the optimality principles next. So before we get into specific algorithm, it may be helpful to note that one can make a general statement about optimal routes without regard to network topology or traffic. So this statement is known as the optimality principle. So it states that if router J is on the optimal path from router I to router K, so here you can see an example for this. And then the optimal path from J to K also falls along the same route to see this call the part of the route from I to J R1 and the rest of the route R2. If a router better than R2 existed from J to K, it could be concatenated with R1 to improve the route from I to K, and contradicting our statement that R1 R2 is optimal. So as a direct consequence of the optimality principle, we can here see that the set of optimal routes from all sources to a given destination from a tree rooted at the destination. So such a tree is called a sync tree, as you can see here in example B. It is example for sync tree for router P, and where the distance metric is the number of hops, and the goal of all routing algorithm is to discover and use the sync trees for all routers. So note again, for the sync tree is not necessarily a unique. Other trees with the same path length may exist, and if we allow all of the possible paths to be chosen, the tree becomes a more general structure called a DAG, directed acyclic graph. So DAG have no loops, and we will use sync tree as a convenient shorthand for both cases, and both cases also depends on the technical assumption that the path do not interfere with each others. And for example, we have a traffic jam on one path will not cause another path to divert. And since a sync tree is indeed a tree, It does not contains any loops, so each packet will be delivered within a finite and bounded number of hops, and in practice life is not so quite easy just like that. And links and routers can go down and come back up during operations. So different routers may have different ideas about the current topology, and also we have quietly fitness the issue of whether each router has to individually acquire the information on which to base its sync tree computation, or whether this information is collected by some other means. So here are the issues related to optimality principles, and the optimality principles and the sync tree provides a benchmark against which other routing algorithms can be measured. So we have studied here about routing algorithm definitions and routing algorithm and optimality of principle. So after that we can study about more about routing algorithms, different routing algorithms. So here the session is ended here, and we will talk about more in next video about routing algorithms. Thank you.